today we're here with Dr. Mary Ann Bishop. She's our research ecologist at the Prince William Sound Science Center. So Mary Ann, what is an ecologist? What does that mean?
I study from the bottom of the food chain up to the top of the food chain. So I go from the phytoplankton and zooplankton up to the next level fish, and then I study birds, which are at the top of the food chain with the marine mammals and the bears.
What's your favorite bird to study?
Well, today my favorite bird is Caspian terns.
What's a cool thing about Caspian terns?
Oh, Caspian terns almost remind you of a flying dinosaur when they call and when you hear them in the air.
And so where do they live in this area in Prince William Sound, Alaska?
So they're piscivores, which means they eat fish.
And a piscivore?
A piscivore.
A piscivore, okay.
Yeah. And what Caspian terns, they come here to breed. And so they breed in groups, which means they breed in a colony, what's called a colony.
Well, can you show us on this map where that is?
Sure. You know, they pick the best spot right at the mouth of the Copper River. They're on one of the barrier islands at the mouth, which means they can catch smoke coming out and all the other bottom fish. There's lots of fish that use this area here as a nursery. So there's a lot of small fish that are easy for them to eat.
So what kinds of fish?
Oh, it's a whole variety. They'll eat little Pacific cods. They'll eat little greenlings. They'll eat smolts, salmon smolts.
Okay.
They'll eat sculpins. In fact, I brought a couple.
Oh, really? Can we check them out?
Sure. So this is a sculpin. This would be a little bit bigger than what they bring back. They tend to bring back some that are a couple inches long. And they'll feed these to the chicks. And
Cassie, its face.
Sure, it's sculpins.
Are they called double uglies too?
Oh, they're kind of endearing.
You think so?
Okay. Sculpins are, yeah. And the other fish, of course, is salmon smolts. There's lots of those coming down. These are actually probably a little bit bigger than, they could actually eat one of these.
So do they like to be studied? I mean, how do they respond to you?
Oh, even when you're a couple hundred yards away from the colony, they'll be dive bombing you.
So you've been dive bombed?
Oh, yes, I've been dive bombed.
Do they actually hit you?
No, they haven't actually hit me. They'd like to, but they haven't yet. So we actually have to approach them very carefully. We set up a blind a distance away where we're hidden, and it's a camouflage blind, and then we walk in the blind to
really
go see them so that they don't even see us as humans.
So know? It's kind of like 007 style?
Right.
Okay.
Right. And then we'll watch them for quite a while because we're looking to see if a lot of these birds have been banded at places down in Oregon and Washington and as far south as California, San Francisco area. We put color bands on so you can tell what colony they're from. And here, let's look.
Oh,
let's look over here. In terms of putting the bands on, so you're going to put this on their leg and then take these pliers and close it up. See how this is set up exactly for that size, and then it closes it up so it doesn't hurt the bird at all.
Okay.
So, and then this, you can say, okay, that's K85. That bird was banded as a chick or whatever. And then
so do you know the year and the location from that?
Oh, yes.
Wow.
Yes. This tells you an individual.
Okay. And
so, yeah, the whole bands can tell us so much. The other thing we've used a lot to be able to learn about birds are transmitters. With these kinds of transmitters, though, you have to fly in a plane to listen for them, and then you hear the bird, you circle the area, you say, okay, that's so-and-so, you know, 164.85.
So I notice you've got a lot more tools going on here. Are there other techniques that you use to collect data?
Oh, sure. Once we catch birds, there's lots of different measurements that we do. In fact, you know, Anne's here, and she brought a volunteer specimen.
Oh, volunteer?
From our freezer, yes.
From the freezer! Wait, do we have a dead bird here?
Yes.
What kind of bird is it?
A dead belted kingfisher, which is also a piscivore.
Oh, it smells.
Oh, sorry about that.
They're also pretty loud birds too, huh?
Oh, yes, they're another one. They kind of sound like Woody Woodpecker. Mm-hmm. And they fly and call.
You want to do that again?
They fly.
Great.
One of the first things we do is weigh it.
Okay,
and if this is
put in a bag.
Use this all the time.
So this one is 152 grams. Yep, and then you weigh the bag and you subtract the weight of the bag from the weight of the bird in the bag.
Makes sense.
These are calipers, and so one thing that we do is we measure the head and bill. And so
well, thanks, Anne. I'm appreciative of you holding the dead bird for us. So when we were looking at all those bands and all those processes, I mean, satellites were even involved. That seems like quite a lot of work. So what kinds of questions are you trying to answer?
Well, with the Caspian terns, there's been a lot of very interesting questions to be answered. And birds tell us what's going on in the food chain. I mean, they're very important. They're, you know, as they say, the canary in the gold mine that tells you when things are changing.